Hey you guys, how you doing? What's up, my brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ? I love you all. God bless. Here to share a dream that I had, that came from God. This is about scoffing and how, you know, people are gonna start persecuting us for sharing Jesus with others and being followers of Him. That we gotta get ready for. All right. I had a dream that I was in a house having dinner with some people. And these people seemed like your average outcast. There were some witches, homeless people, rich, and even just lost people in general. I began telling them about Jesus Christ. And many actually were interested and wanted to listen to me. But I remember there was this very angry, rude, and resentful woman who tried to keep me from sharing and tried to persuade people from listening to me. I remember she kept kicking me out, away from talking to people in what seemed like a mob. But I kept coming back to spread the good news to all the outcasts, and I made her so mad by how I kept returning to talk to people about Jesus that she called some type of security on me, and a woman came and grabbed me, and as I was pulled by her away from telling people about Jesus, I kept talking and saying, I think, as much as I could about Jesus and how much He loved them all. She was pulling me away and I was kind of yelling. I was like saying, Jesus loves you all, remember my words to you and what I said as she was pulling me away. This woman pulled me away. I even began telling her Jesus loves you too. She wouldn't listen. She had taken me to what I thought was a security room, but looked like a hotel room of some kind. I then looked at her and her face changed. She was mad. Her teeth became sharp and her eyes became pitch pure black. And I knew she was demon possessed. She then made a weird gesture with her body. The way she looked was, she looked at me and she looked completely evil. And then she kind of went like this, or something like that. And then like this. When she did that, and made this weird gesture with her body, seemed like she was trying to see whose king was strongest between hers and mine. She called upon some demonic spirit, and I saw a blue and black mist form around her. But she had no power over me, and then I woke up. Alright you guys, so when this happened, she became completely demon possessed. Her eyes were pitch black, even the white part. Her teeth were razor sharp. Long black hair looking all crazy. Long fingernails. And she sounded really weird. And she challenged me. She was trying to say, like, Satan is stronger than God. I did not do anything. I just looked at her. I told her that Jesus loves you before she even tried to challenge me like that. And she had no power over me. When she called upon this demonic spirit and this blue and black mist formed over her body, nothing happened to me. Not a thing. She had no power. Satan has no power over you. He only has the power that you allow him to have. All he can do is scare you. And at the end, Jesus has already won. It is written, Jesus has already won. And Satan is nothing but an ant that will get squashed. I'm going to read to you what Jesus says about when we preach the gospel in the last days that we are in right now, that many need to hear and know and take with you. Be prepared for scoffing. Be prepared for persecution. Be prepared for being arrested for speaking the name of Jesus Christ to others. Be prepared to be made fun of. Just know you are doing a good thing. You are doing the right thing when people hate you because of Jesus. Because Jesus said that when people make fun of you and laugh at you and arrest you and persecute you all because of him, rejoice. Be glad when that happens and dance with joy. For they did the very same things to the prophets. I'm going to read to you John 18 through 26. The world's hatred. If the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hated you. If you were of the world would love you as its own. Yet because you are not of the world, but I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you. Remember, the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will keep yours also. But all these things they will do to you for my name's sake, because they do not know him who sent me. If I had not come and spoken to them, they would have no sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. He who hates me hates my Father also. If I had not done among them the works which no one else did, they would have no sin. But now they have seen and also hated both me and my Father. But this happened that the word might be fulfilled, which is written in their law. They hated me without a cause. But when the Helper comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will testify of me. And you also will bear witness, because you have been with me from the beginning. Amen. Alright, you guys. So, be prepared, because scoffers will come. They will make fun of you. They will try to make you feel bad. They will laugh at you. They will call you stupid and a fool and every other name they can think of to make you feel bad. And all they want to do is try to prevent you from doing your works that God has called you to do. Do not let them bring you down. Rejoice and pray for your enemies. Love them, even though they make fun of you. Just like Jesus was hanging on the cross, he said to the Father, Father, forgive them. They don't know. They know not what they do. Pray for your enemies. I know it can be hard sometimes, but pray for them. Because one day, and it's very close, one day, no one will be scoffing anymore. And all will see Son of God and the Father. praying for your enemies. I hope this was a blessing to you. Praise God. Glory to God. Amen. Amen and amen. Alright. I hope this bless you guys. Alright. I love you all. Stay praying. Stay fasting. Stay reading your word and seeking God's face all the time. More than ever now. Because we are in the last days. Shalom.